The Bhagnanis, father and producer Vashu, son and leading man Jackie, are the creators of a unique Bollywood franchise. Every other year or so, Vashu produces a film in which Jackie stars. These vanity projects have been uniformly mediocre, but their fifth film together, Youngistan, sets a new standard of ridiculous.
बहुत ध्यान से सुनो जो मैं कहने जा रहा हूँ। राष्ट्रपति भवन के अशोक हॉल में एक सेरेमनी ऑर्गेनाइज की जाएगी। इसमें I will be sworn in by the honorable president of India as the prime minister of this country.
It's not funny.
In Youngistan, Jackie plays Abhimanyu Kaul, a 28-year-old games developer who is suddenly upgraded to the position of Indian prime minister because his father, who is the PM, dies. The film, directed by debutant Syed Ahmed Afzal, attempts to explore what happens when a young, idealistic political novice who happens to have a live-in girlfriend takes over the reins of the country. The premise had the potential for drama and humor, but Youngistan is just an incoherent mess designed to make us fall in love with Jackie, who is in almost every frame. He's either giving inspiring speeches about the state of the nation, or suggesting banking reforms, or outmaneuvering political foes. When his girlfriend sees him on television for the first time, she says, "For some reason, it's turning me on."
अगर इसके चलते आपको लगता है कि मैं अपने कर्तव्य से चूका हूँ, तो मुझे वोट मत दीजिए, पर वोट जरूर दीजिए, क्योंकि ये आपका हक है। जय हिंद।
The only bright spot here is the late Farooq Sheikh, who brings his good-natured gravitas to this unintentional comedy. Otherwise, Youngistan is brain dead and largely insufferable. I'm going with one star. In the beginning of O Teri, we have our heroes partying in a nightclub with leggy blondes singing, "You got me going crazy with your butt patlo." I think that means thin rear end.
You got me going crazy with your butt patlo. You got me going crazy with your butt patlo.
At the end of O Teri, we have a quick salute to Mahatma Gandhi with the quote, "Be the change you wish to see." That should give you some idea of how schizophrenic the film is. In between these two extremes, director Umesh Bisht gives us the cheerfully low IQ story of two television reporters unwittingly caught up in scams created by corrupt politicians, greedy industrialists and fraudulent media. There's a bridge that collapses, an unethical female editor and even a dead body that is carted from one location to another. Yes, it's Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro reduced to noise and nonsense. A sample dialogue. लोहार को अपने हथौड़े पे और मर्द को अपने घोड़े पे पूरा यकीन करना चाहिए. वेटरन्स लाइक अनुपम खेर एंड विजय राज हैम. पुलकित सम्राट, हु मेड अ फाइन इंप्रेशन विद फुकरे, फॉलोज इन देयर फुटस्टेप्स. न्यूबी बिलाल अमरोही डिस्प्लेज इंप्रेसिव मसल्स बट लिटिल टैलेंट. आफ्टर अ वाइल माई आईज ग्लेज्ड ओवर एंड माई ब्रेन शट डाउन. Eventually, all that registered was Mandira Bedi's lovely noodle strap blouses. One even had pearls sewn on it. I'm going with 1.5 stars. Darren Aronofsky's Noah is a peculiar experience. The biblical epic begins at a plodding pace. We are introduced to Noah, played by Russell Crowe, a man whom Aronofsky described as the first environmentalist. Noah and his family are chosen by the creator to be the sole survivors of a catastrophic flood that will destroy the rest of mankind. Aided by gigantic rock-like angels, Noah creates the ark, in which he, his family, and two of every species on Earth will float until it's time to start the world again. I don't know the biblical story well enough to tell you how much Aronofsky and his co-writer Ari Handel have deviated from the original, but in this version, Noah's task leads to a momentous struggle and eventually tears his family apart. Crowe delivers a strong performance as a man ravaged by his convictions. There are moments of great visual beauty, sweeping shots of birds and all kinds of animals making their way to the ark. And later in the film, Aronofsky gives us a dazzling creation story. From darkness to the birth of life. The gargantuan ark, like a floating wooden box, is marvelous. But the story itself is weighed down by tonal inconsistency, veering between a disaster story, a family drama, and an exploration of divine intervention versus free will. It's labored and eventually exhausting. If you have the patience and willingness to see a flawed but ambitious film by an intriguing and talented director, then Noah is worth your time. I'm going with 2.5 stars.